orang lain cari nei di sisa senyawati aja cintana ini
jaya si Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasudeva
Narayanam Namaskritam
Narayanam Namaskritam
Naram Chaiva Narottamam
Narayanam Narottamam
Devim Sarasvatim
सरस्वतीं व्यासं
देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं
ततो जयमुदीरयः
ततो जयमुदीरयः
नस्त प्रयेषु भवद्रेषु
नस्त प्रयेषु भवद्रेषु
नित्यं भागवत सेवया
नित्यं भागवत सेवया
भागवत्युत्तमश्लोके
भागवत्युत्तमश्लोके
भक्तिर्भवति नैष्टिकी
भक्तिर्भवति नैष्टिकी.
We're going through the prayers by Queen Kunti, which I offered in the Srimad Bhagavatam in the first canto, chapter 8. On the board, you can see it on the screen. Kechidahur ajam jatam.
Kechidahur ajam jatam.
Kechidahur ajam jatam.
Kechidahur ajam jatam.
Punya shlokasya kirtaye.
Punya shlokasya kirtaye.
Punya shlokasya kirtaye.
Punya shlokasya kirtaye.
Yado priyasya mahvahi vahye.
Yado priyasya mahvahye.
Yado priyasya mahvahye.
Yado priyasya mahvahye.
Malayasya eva chandana.
Malayasya eva chandana.
Kechidahura jam jatam.
Kechidahura jam jatam.
Punya shloka shakirtaye.
Punya shloka shakirtaye.
Yado priyasya vavaye.
Yado priyasya vavaye.
Malayasya eva chandana.
Malayasya eva chandana.
Kechit ahorajam jatam.
Kechit ahorajam jatam.
Punya slokasya kirtaye.
Punya slokasya kirtaye.
Yato priyasya vavaye.
Yato priyasya vavaye.
Malayasya eva chandana.
Malayasya eva chandana.
Anyone?
Ahurajam jatam.
Ahurajam jatam.
Lokasya Kirtaye.
Vrindyasya Lokasya Kirtaye.
Yalopi Yasyan Mabaye.
Yalopi Yasyan Mabaye.
Malayasyeva Chandanam.
Malayasyeva Chandanam.
Kichit Ahura Jamjatam.
Kichit Ahura Jamjatam.
Shokasya Kirtaye.
Vrindyasya Kirtaye.
Yalo Priyasya Vanyavaye.
Yalo Priyasya Vanyavaye.
Vanasya Vesya Chandanam.
Vanasya Vesya Chandanam.
Kirtika
Hura Jamjatam.
Shokasya Kirtaye.
Vrindyasya Kirtaye.
有些人说，那些未经出生的是出于虔诚的国王的荣耀而出生，而其他人则说呢，他的出生是为了取悦亚度国王，他是亚度国王是在这个亲爱的奉献者，您亲爱的奉献者之中的一个，你在这个家庭里面出生就像是在。
马来亚山里面的檀香那样的芬芳。Yes。Om Mani Padme Hum Tathagata Shri Guru Namaha。Sri Chaitanya Prabhu Krishna Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kalpam Yam Vakshakapatarubhyasya Kripa Sindhu Daivacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasati Gaura Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
So in the previous verse, Queen Kunti was describing the contradictions which appear in the pastime of Krishna.
在前面的诗节里面，昆蒂皇后在描述的关于Kusha的逍遥时光里面所谓的相对冲突性。
She was saying that Krishna is unborn, but he is born. He takes his birth as a child of Vasudeva and Devaki.
就是Kusha他是未经出生的，可是他又展示出出生于Devaki跟瓦苏代瓦。
So now in the verse tonight, and in a few other verses to come, Queen Kunti will discuss different reasons why the Lord appears in this world.
接着的诗节呢，昆蒂皇后来讨论着说，为什么主他的出现是这样子？
And she says in the verse here tonight, she said, the unborn. So she's describing Lord Krishna as the unborn.
就像今天这个诗节里面说到，Krishna是不经出生的，Krishna不是经由出生而出现的。
Krishna has a spiritual body.
Krishna有灵性的身体。
So spiritual bodies don't take birth.
灵性的身体不经由出生。
So Lord Krishna is unborn.
所以 Krishna是不经由出生出现的。
We're also spirit souls. We all the spirit soul never takes birth.
我们都是灵魂，但是我们不需要经过投胎的出生。
Right. In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna describes, for the soul, there is never birth nor death.
在《牡丹梵歌》里面有描述，就是说对于灵魂的而言呢，是既没有出生，也没有死亡。
So in a sense, we are also unborn.
嗯，所以同样这样的道理呢，我们也是啊、不经出生的。
But we identify ourselves with the body.
嗯，可是我们认同的身体了。
For the body.The body is born, the body takes birth, and the body also dies.
所以对于这个身体躯体呢，它是要经过出生，而且会有死亡。
But for the soul, there's no birth and there is no death.
但对于灵魂而言呢，没有出生，也没有死亡。
So Queen Kunti is giving some different reasons why Lord Krishna would appear to be born.
嗯、那昆蒂皇后就举出了几个理由，就是为什么 Krishna 的出现就像出生这个样子。
And she says one of the reasons is for the glorification of pious kings.、
嗯、那其中一个理由就是为了来荣耀那些虔诚的国王们。
Not all of the kings were all demons. There were also pious kings.
啊，并非所有的国王都是恶魔，有一些国王是虔诚的。
And Lord Krishna took birth. One reason why he might have taken birth was to glorify these pious kings.
嗯，那 Krishna 他会这样出现的出生，有一个理由就是要来赞扬荣耀这一些虔诚的国王。
Lord Krishna himself says in Bhagavad Gita.That he comes into this world to give pleasure to the devotees.
嗯，可是在《博迦梵歌》里面有说呢，他的出现的一个原因呢，就是来给他的奉献者快乐。
He doesn't just come to kill demons, but is much more interested to give pleasure to the devotees.
嗯，他并不是只是出来杀除恶魔。他是更多的快乐在于来给予奉献者快乐。
So Queen Kunti suggests that Lord Krishna took birth in this world so that he could glorify the pious kings.、
嗯、所以昆蒂皇后就解释着说，就是 Krishna 在这个世界的这样的出生呢，可以有这个机会来直接赞扬这些虔诚的国王。
But then she goes on to pick out another great devotee of Lord Krishna.Named King Yadu.
嗯，昆蒂皇后接着又提出一个 Krishna 的一个伟大奉献者，就是亚杜国王。
And she said he could have been born just to give pleasure to King Yadu, who was one of Lord Krishna's dearest devotees.
嗯，昆蒂皇后说 ，Krishna 是可以只是为了来啊荣耀亚杜国王而出现。因为亚杜国王呢，他是 Krishna 很多亲爱的奉献者之中的一位。
So Lord Krishna likes to please his devotees.、
嗯、所以 Krishna 他很喜欢去取悦他的奉献者们。
He likes to satisfy the desires of the devotee.、
嗯、他也喜欢来满足他奉献者的愿望。
And the devotees all desire to enjoy loving relationships with Krishna.、
嗯、然后奉献者们都在享受着跟 Krishna 这种爱的关系。
Just like when Krishna lived in Dwarka.
嗯、就像 Krishna 住在 Dwarka 的时候
Sometimes he would go out of Dwarka to go and visit some of the different devotees、
嗯、有些时候 Krishna 会、离开 Dwarka 然后去拜访一些奉献者们
And when Lord Krishna would go, he wouldn't go alone、嗯、But he'd go with all of his ministers and his some of the sons andThen great sages who were also living there in Dwarka, they would all follow Lord Krishna.
嗯，那 Krishna 出去的时候不是自己，他自己一个，他都会带着他的那一些所谓布政大臣呐、啊，还有他家族的一些人呐、啊，还有他的一些儿子们一起出去。
So Srimad Bhagavatam describes how one occasion Lord Krishna had gone to visit.Two of his very dear devotees.
嗯，所以《博迦瓦坛》里面有描述呢 ，Krishna 有一次去拜访他一个非常亲爱的奉献者。
One was the Brahmana Shrutadeva.
嗯，其中一个婆罗门叫 Shrutadeva.
And the other was a king called Bahulaspa.
嗯，另外一位是一个国王 Bahulaspa.
they both lived in the the Brahmana lived in the same kingdom where King Bahulaspa was living.
那个婆罗门呢，之前是住在这国王Bahulaspa的这个王国里面。
And when Lord Krishna came there to visit them, Lord Krishna arranged to expand not only himself, but all of the people who were with him. They also expanded so that there were two groups.
那当 Krishna 去到那儿的时候呢，不止 Krishna 自己，他把他的那些随从人员同样都在扩展复制，变成说变成有两组人马去到这两个人家里。
Lord Krishna in one group went to visit the Brahmana Shukadeva.
Krishna 这一组呢就去拜访这个婆罗门 Shukadeva.
And the Brahmana Shukadeva, he's a Brahmana, he's no wealth, he's very poor.
这个婆罗门 Shukadeva 他是一个婆罗门，所以就是生活清贫。
So Shukadeva was very happy to welcome Lord Krishna into his humble home.
Shukadeva 非常的高兴 Krishna 来到他简陋的屋子。
He swept the floor.
然后他就打扫啊，扫地弄得干干净净。
And he put some straw on the ground for Lord Krishna to sit.
然后地上也铺了一些草啊，就是当做一个垫子，让 Krishna 可以坐。
And then he brought some simple fruits which were available there.
他也去带了一些当地可以有找到的水果。
He didn't have any opulent foodstuffs to offer to Lord Krishna.
他没有什么所谓富裕的像东西来招待 Krishna.
He didn't have any luxurious comforts to give Krishna.
而且也没有说家里有什么华丽啦、舒适的设备让 Krishna 可以在里面。
But Lord Krishna is not worried about that.
可是 Krishna 对这些一点也不会觉得操心。
Lord Krishna is just happy to be with his devotee.
Krishna 只是很高兴、快乐的跟他的奉献者们在一起。
And the Brahmana Shukadeva brought some water to give to Lord Krishna.
这个婆罗门 Shukadeva 就是用水来招待 Krishna.
And they enjoyed sitting together and talking.
然后他们就是互相都很享受这样彼此在一起的交流。
And at the same time, in the palace of King Bahulaspa, Lord Krishna was also there with his entourage, with the same entourage which had come to the home of Shukadeva.
那在这同时 ，Krishna 的扩展的另外一组人马呢，去到这个国王Bahulaspa 这个国王家里，那这一群人一样受到这个国王的招待。
Now the king Bahulaspa, he's in the palace and he has a lot of luxury. He's very comfortable. He gave a beautiful throne to Lord Krishna to sit on.
这个国王 Bahulaspa 的地方嘛，当然很丰富很华丽，也有很舒适的座椅，让 Krishna 可以在里面舒舒服服的坐着。
He prepared a royal reception for Lord Krishna.
然后用皇家的规格来迎接 Krishna.
He gave Krishna a beautiful flower garland with very fragrant flowers.
然后给这 Krishna 献上非常美丽又芳香的花环。
And he brought beautiful.Foodstuffs to present to Krishna.
然后也准备了非常这个美丽的水果佳肴来招待 Krishna.
There were sweets and there were salty items.
这有甜品的，还有咸的食物。
There were savories. There were all kinds of different foodstuffs.
就是说水果也有啦，甜的食品啊，还有点心，各种点心类，通通都有。
Some were cooked in ghee.
有一些食物呢，用那个酥油来烹制煮的。
Others were nicely prepared expert cooks.
然后其他的食物品项呢，也是由那个烹饪专家所煮出来的。
And there were all different kinds of refreshments for Lord Krishna.
然后也有很多就是说提神的东西来供奉给 Krishna。
Lord Krishna sat before an array of so many different foodstuffs and drinks.
所以 Krishna 的面前就摆满了各种各样的食物啦、饮料啦、果汁、水果，很丰富。
And the king had poets come and sing beautiful songs for the pleasure of Krishna.
然后，这个国王也安排一些诗人呢。来朗诵美丽的诗节来欢迎取悦 Krishna.
Lord Krishna was enjoying the company of his devotees.
Krishna 享受着他奉献者的陪伴。
He didn't make any distinction between one being rich and one being poor.
所以 Krishna 没有去说有什么分别，对一个富有的，对一个比较贫穷，他没有那种分别心。
They were both his pure unalloyed devotees.
他们这两位都是 Krishna 纯粹没有任何杂质的奉献。
And Lord Krishna was appreciating their devotion.
那 Krishna 非常的欣赏他们的奉爱。
He'd come to visit them and enjoy their company.
所以Krishna 就亲自去拜访他们，然后享受跟他们在一起的时光。
So Queen Kunti says.One reason why Krishna appeared in this world could have been to give pleasure to these pious kings.
所以昆蒂皇后就说呢 ，Krishna 出现的一个理由呢，就是说他来给这些虔诚的国王们，给他们这种快乐。
Or maybe he just came because of King Yadu.
或者呢，他只是为了这个亚杜国王而出来。
Because King Yadu was such a great devotee that he wanted to please him.
因为亚杜国王是这么一个伟大的奉献者，所以 Krishna 很想取悦他。
But then Queen Kunti says that he appears just like.Sandalwood appears in the Malaya Hills.
那这个昆蒂皇后说 ，Krishna 的出现呢，就像在马来亚山的檀香木那样的。
So there's the Malaya Hills, and there's also a country called Malaysia. They're different.
当然了，有这个马来山，但是也有个国家叫马来西亚，但这是不同地方。
But they have something in common.
但是这两个地方有一些相同的。
The thing in common is sandalwood.
这两处呢，有一个共同的点，就是都出产檀香木。
At least 5,000 years ago, a long time ago, 5,000 years. There was a lot of sandalwood.
至少在5000年前的时候。有很多的檀香木
，and that sandalwood would be of course very valuable, very useful for many purposes.
当然了，檀香木是非常有价值的，在很多方面非常有很好的价值。
Usually, when we have a Prabhupada Murti, it is the custom that every day we should put chandan on Prabhupada's forehead.
一般呢，之前呢，我们对 Prabhupada 的供奉呢，每一天会做檀香浆，然后抹在 Prabhupada 的额头上。
We do this in Hong Kong. We do this wherever we have a Prabhupada Murti.
这个也在香港是这样进行的，还有在世界各地有的 Prabhupada 的像坐像时候都有这么做。
I was in Mayapur, and I asked Janani Vas Prabhu, who was the head pujari in Mayapur. I asked him about did Prabhupada take chandan in the winter time?
当我在 Mayapur 的那段时间，我也问了那个首席祭司 Janani Vas Prabhu， 就是说啊，Prabhupada 在冬天的时候，你们也帮他涂上檀香浆吗？
And he told me, he said. everyday Prabhupada took chanda. Everyday Prabhupada wanted chanda.
Janalimas Prabhu 就说每一天 Prabhupada 都要给他涂上檀香浆。
Now usually, of course, you know, we think chanda and sandalwood, it's cooling on the body, makes the body very cool.
我们一般说呢，一般的想法就是檀香会让人就是清凉。
And usually you think in the summer it's very nice to put on the body, cool the body.
而且通常我们认为在冬天，夏天的时候太热了，涂上檀香浆就会让人觉得一种清爽。
And people often put the tilak, they'll use sandalwood.
而且呢，有奉献的。用檀香浆来当成提拉克的泥来画。
And sometimes we will put the different symbols of Vishnu on the body, and we will use the sandalwood to do that.
同样的，有时候我们在身体的不同地方呢，画上这个主 Vishnu 的各种标志，也是檀香浆来画。
So putting sandalwood on the body, it's like a cosmetic, you know, just like you get some cosmetics to put on your skin.
所以呢，涂上檀香浆就有点像我们说化妆品一样，给它装饰。
But it's a natural thing to put on.
檀香浆呢是一种自然产物，非化学的。
So in the past, that sandalwood was found especially in the Malaya Hills. And also in Malaysia.
在过去呢，檀香木呢，可以在这个马来山，还有在马来西亚，盛产，可以那边去得到这个檀香木。
If you go to Malaysia, you can see there's a lot of forests there, many, many mountains covered in trees.
如果说大家有去到马来西亚的话，可以去看呢。有非常多的森林，非常多的树在那儿。
Over the years, of course, there's been less and less sandalwood there.
当然，随着时间的流逝，他们那儿的檀香木越来越少了。
And instead of having sandalwood, they started to make plantations of rubber trees.
就是说他们渐渐去种那个橡胶树来取代檀香木。
The price of rubber, however, fluctuated, and at one point the price of rubber went very low, and they decided the people who owned the plantations stopped growing rubber trees, stopped having rubber trees, and they switched to palm oil.
那么，这个。这个过程的转变呢，就是檀香木被这个橡胶树取代。那有一阵子种的太多了，橡胶树的价值贬得非常低了，所以那一些耕作的人就全部把这个橡胶树除掉，然后开始种植那一些像棕榈树、椰子树那一类的大棵的那个棕榈。
Then some time back, then the price of rubber came up again.
可是一段时间之后，这物极必反，那个橡胶的这个什么市价又渐渐回升了。
And some people stopped growing palm oil and went back to rubber trees.
那有一些在就是已经种的那一些那个。椰子油或什么其他的棕榈油的又砍掉，然后又回头去再种橡胶树。
But in the times of Lord Krishna and the times of Queen Kunti, at that time in the Malaysia and in the Malaya Hills, there was sandalwood there.
当在Krishna 在这个地球上的时候呢，在马来山跟马来西亚的是很普遍的风。盛产的这个檀香木。
Prabhupada talked about sandalwood. He said, if you have just one sandalwood tree in the whole forest, the whole forest becomes very beautiful. It smells very nice.
啊，包括他提到的檀香木呢，他说到，如果整片森林、整片树林只要有一株檀香木，这整片森林都会非常的芳香。
Prabhupada gave this example, and he was writing to a devotee, a Hong Kong devotee, the first Chinese devotee, and he joined in Hong Kong, and Prabhupada wrote to him like that.
嗯啊，包括他曾经呢，就是说有一封信，他写给一个啊，就是在中国人里面的第一位奉献者，他是在香港，包括他有写信给他过。
He said, "You are the devotee. You're the first Chinese devotee. So you are like one sandalwood tree in the forest of so many other trees."
那包括他这样写信给他，跟他说。你是第一个中国的奉献者，那你就像这个整片森林里面的那一棵檀香木。
And that one tree beautifies the whole forest.
嗯，那就是这样一棵树让整个森林美化起来了。
So sandalwood, of course, does not have to appear only in the hills of Malaysia or the Malaya Hills.
当然呢，檀香木 并不必要只出现在马来山或是马来西亚。
And the same way, Lord Krishna can appear anywhere he likes.、
嗯、所以同样的情况 ，Krishna 可以、在他愿意、他喜欢的地方出现。
Lord Krishna comes. Generally, he will come where his devotees are.
嗯、那 Krishna 会来到的地方呢，一般而言都是他奉献者在的这个地方。
He will send his devotees there, first of all.
当然，首先 Krishna 会把他的奉献者派到那些地方。
Just like his mother and father and other elderly people, they will all take their birth first, and then Lord Krishna will.
嗯、就像如果在 Krishna 的显现之中呢、啊、Krishna 的家族 Krishna 的父母亲当然先在这个地球上出现然后再接着是 Krishna 在这个家族里面出现
Lord Chaitanya appeared in Mayapur but before Lord Chaitanya came there first of all Sachimata and Jagannath Mishra were there
啊、像主持太妈婆布他在这个玛雅普出现当然在主持太妈出现之前就是他的妈妈萨奇玛达他的父亲啊加格纳米舍拉就先在玛雅普这个地方
And Advaita Acharya with his family they were also there they were of course usually in Shantipur but they also had a house in MayapurAdvaita Acharya was very much senior to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in age.
当然呢，还有 Advaita Acharya， 他们在 Mayapur 也有房子。他们当然原来是在 Shantipur 那边，但是他们在 Mayapur 也有房子。那当然呢 ，Advaita Acharya 比主 Chaitanya 年长了很多，年纪更大。
When Advaita Acharya was about 60 years old. That was when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared.
嗯，所以呢，当 Advaita Acharya 超过六十岁的时候，主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 才显现。
So he was so much senior in age, and he was responsible for calling Lord Chaitanya to come.
嗯，所以呢，他在年龄上比主 Chaitanya 所谓年纪大了很多，但是他承担一个责任就是。由他的请求的呼喊，请求主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 出现在这个地球。
Lord Chaitanya would sometimes chastise Advaita and say, "I was sleeping in the spiritual world, and you woke me up with your loud calling."
主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 有时候会这样去对着 Advaita Acharya 说：“我在灵性世界，在那边睡着哈。”可是你呀、啊，我被你那个爱的呼唤叫醒，你在叫唤着我过来。
You call me to come here, and you're preaching this Mayavada philosophy.
对他就有点责备，说你把我叫到这里来了，可是你是在传扬那一些假象中的哲学。
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was chastising Advaita.
所以主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就在那边责备 Advaita.
But sometimes also Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would give great respect to Advaita.
但有些时候呢，主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 对 Advaita Acharya 表现啊，就是说至上很崇高的敬意。
And we see also Lord Krishna do similar things with his devotees.
啊，我们看到 Krishna 对他的奉献者们有时候也做这样类似的事情。
Just like Lord Krishna was instructing Nanda Maharaj not to do the Indra Yagya.
就像主持的阿玛 Krishna 呢，在指示着这个南达大军不要去对因陀罗做出就是做供奉因陀罗。
Lord Krishna is only 7 years old. He's only a child, but he's telling his father, "Don't worship Indra. Don't do this Indra Yagya."
啊 ，Krishna 那时候只有7岁，但是他已经在跟他父亲说了，只是不要去对 Indra 做这些崇拜。
And Lord Krishna convinced his father not to worship Indra.
而 Krishna 也说服他父亲不要做这个因陀罗的崇拜。
So although he appears as a young child, he's always the supreme Lord.
虽然他出现是一个小孩，可是他身份永远都是至尊主。
And though he's saying that he appears in the Malaya Hills, he's not obliged to appear there. He can appear anywhere.
然后这边叙述说主他出现在马来山，可是呢，Krishna 没有义务绝对要在那边出现。Krishna 可以选择任何他想要的地方去出现。
Generally, the Lord will appear according to the incarnations which are described in revealed scriptures.
一般而言，主他会出现的在什么地方，会根据那些启示经典所揭示的讯息的地点去出现。
We recognize who is the incarnation of the Lord, who is actually the Lord. When the Lord is coming, we have to recognize on the basis of scripture.
我们呢要去辨认谁是真正的主，而且他在什么地方出现呢，就必须要以那个权威的正宗的经典的描述来确认。
All of the Lord's incarnations are mentioned in the scriptures.
主的所有的化身都被经典所描述了。
And we have to use the scriptures to provide evidence to prove the identity of the Lord.
我们必须要好好应用这些经典当作这个证明主的真正身份，他真正的出现。
Just like Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is identified on the basis of scripture.
就像主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他的身份也是经典上所认同证明的。
Lord Chaitanya is a special incarnation. He's a covered incarnation. He doesn't reveal himself as God.
主 Chaitanya 他是一个隐藏真正身份的一个化身，他出现不是神的身份出现。
Lord Krishna comes, and Lord Krishna says to everyone, "Mata parataram nanyat kinchid asti damanja." There is no truth superior to me.
那 Krishna 呢又不一样。 Krishna 就是他的出现，他就说没有其他的真理高过于我。
Lord Krishna said everything rests on me, just like the pearls are strung on a thread.
那 Krishna 也说了，所有的一切都被我所牵系着，就像这些珍珠串在一起。
And Lord Krishna said, "Give up all religion and just surrender to me."
主 Krishna 也说呢，放弃所有的宗教而来向我臣服。
So Lord Krishna can speak in this way because he is the Supreme Lord.
主 Krishna 可以以这样的方式来说的，因为他是至尊主。
And he displayed all of the opulences of the Supreme Lord.
所以他就带着所有至尊主的富裕这样出现。
All of the different six opulences which are associated with Bhagavan. They were all displayed in the pastimes of Lord Krishna.
那啊，至尊主 Krishna 他的各项六种富裕是 Bhagavan， 他都在这个 Krishna 的各种逍遥时光里面展示出来。
The wealth which Krishna had as the king of Dwarka was inconceivable.
如果说财富的富裕方面呢 ，Krishna 展示在 Dwarka， Dwarka 的那一些富裕是我们不可思议的。
You know, in England, they have a king, and the king has a crown which he will wear. He has one crown.
我当然知道英国他们还是有国王的存在，一个国王肯定戴着皇冠哈。
And just your ego, he only has one.
国王只有一个皇冠。
But Krishna had 16,108 queens, and each and every queen was decorated with crowns and so many valuable jewels and ornaments.
英国那么一个大英帝国国王只有一个皇冠，但是 Krishna 在 Dwarka 有16,000个这个皇后，这些皇后们每个人都有自己的皇冠，16,000个皇冠。
So the opulence of Krishna, the wealth which he had was inconceivable, and then the knowledge which he had, he spoke the Bhagavad Gita in a short time on a battlefield.
那刚刚这个是 Krishna 在啊财富方面的富裕已经不可思议了。那在关于啊知识方面呢，像 Krishna 这个在波迦梵歌这些讲述是在战场上很短的时间把它讲述出来。
We spend our lives reading Bhagavad Gita.
但是我们花了一生的时间在那边研究波迦梵歌。
So Lord Krishna had wealth, he had knowledge, he had strength.As a little seven-year-old child, he picked up the Govardhan Hill and held it up.
Krishna 的财富的富裕啦，知识的富裕啦，还有力量上的富裕啊，就像说他只是一个小孩，七岁而已就可以把 Govardhan 山举起来那样的力量。
He has fame which is even there today.
而且 Krishna 的名望是这样子，遍布各地，直到现在还是很有名望的。
And he has also beauty.
而且在美的方面 ，Krishna 也是具有完全的美。
That he doesn't get old, his body is eternally spiritual, eternally youthful.
就是 Krishna 不会变老，永远青春，他的身体是永远的青春。
And at the same time, Krishna is renowned.
虽然拥有一切 ，Krishna 同时也是弃绝，一点都不执着任何一切。
He's not attached to any of these things.
对于这一些 ，Krishna 一点都不执着。
And he can give up everything.
就是他可以随时放弃所有一切。
So Lord Krishna shows the opulences of Bhagavan, and he establishes himself as the supreme Lord, and this is confirmed in the scriptures.
所以 Krishna 他表展示出他的富裕，他被称为 Bhagavan， 而且这一切都在经典上描述的他的这一些特质。
And Srimad Bhagavatam said, "Ete chamsala, ete chamsakala punsa."Krishna's to Bhagavan Swayam, that Lord Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
所以在圣典波迦瓦坦有这样确认的这一点，就是 Krishna 是至尊人格首神。
So Lord Krishna is established and he's accepted by great devotees also, as said by Arjuna in the Bhagavad Gita. Arjuna said,I accept you, not only do I accept you, but also other great personalities like Asita and Devala, Narada, Vyasa, they all accept you as the Supreme.
那在波迦梵歌里面 Krishna 也说了、我接受你是至尊主，不只是我，很多伟大的人士呢， Asita, Devala,
Narada,
Narada 啦
，Vyasa,
Vyasa 啦，等等，这经典描述这些伟大的圣者们都接受你是至尊主。
What about Lord Chaitanya? However, he's a different person. He's also Krishna, but he's a covered personality. He doesn't reveal himself as God.
那至于主 Chaitanya 呢？他是 Krishna 本人，可是他是隐藏身份的。他没有展示出他是至尊主的身份。
He doesn't allow anyone to call him as God.
主 Chaitanya 不允许任何人称他为神。
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is a covered incarnation.
主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 是一个掩盖起来的。
Because in the Kali Yuga, it's understood that there will be many imposters, there will be many people coming, claiming that they are God, they're the supreme.
因为在卡利年代呢，会有很多人是那伪装假扮，然后会就是说宣称自己是至尊主，然后也这种假装的身份。
So Lord Chaitanya doesn't want to be just like one of them. He wants to make it very clear to people that he's not God, but he's coming as a devotee of God.
那主 Chaitanya 他不想要这样子，因为人们会去模仿，那去宣称自己是神。主 Chaitanya 不喜欢这样子的事情发生。
So he comes as a devotee. Why? Because Lord Krishna had told everyone to surrender to him, but he had not shown everyone how to surrender to him. Therefore, Krishna came again as Lord Chaitanya, and as Lord Chaitanya, he's showing us how to surrender.
那主 Chaitanya 出来奉献者的身份出现来教导人们要怎么样臣服，因为 Krishna 的出现的时候呼唤大家要向主来臣服，但是没有告诉大家怎么臣服，所以他又再出现一次来教导大家如何来臣服。
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is coming as a devotee and we are saying Sri Krishna Chaitanya Radha Krishna Nahi Anya. We are saying that Lord Chaitanya is the combined form of Radha and Krishna.
那这主 Chaitanya 以奉献者的身份出现，而我们也说到，就是主 Chaitanya 就是 Radha 跟 Krishna 合并一起的出现。
So are we making a mistake? Are we offending Lord Chaitanya? Are we going against the philosophy?
那我们这样的情况，有任何错吗？还是说跟哲学有相冲突，或者我们有冒犯到主 Chaitanya 吗？
Well, the Acharyas they give evidence from the scriptures to support that to show that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is actually Krishna.
那 Acharya 他们呢拿出证据证明就是这个主 Chaitanya 的这个身份的叙述。
And it is described there in the Srimad Bhagavatam. In the 11th canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, there's a discussion between the nine yogendras and Maharaj Nimi.
那在圣典伯加瓦坛第十一篇里面呢，有一些叙述这个 yogendra 跟这个 Nimi 这个圣人他们在讨论对话。
So the nine yogendras were asked by Maharaj Nimi.He wanted to know about the Lord's incarnations in each age.
所以这个尼米王呢，他就向这个九位有跟爪来询问，因为他们想要知道关于主的各种情况。
And they described how in the Kali Yuga the Lord will come, and he will be his business will be Krishna.
那么他们就描述的就是说在卡利年代呢主也会再出现，那他们的专注的核心是 Krishna。
The verse goes Krishna Varna to Vish Akrishna. The verse is saying that the incarnation of the Lord in Kali Yuga he will be engaged in the activities all connected to Krishna.
所以这是 Krishnamana 的一些叙述，就是说啊，这样的描述，在卡利年代呢，所有人所进行的活动呢，都是跟 Krishna 有所关联关系的。
And so Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was doing like that. He was telling everyone, Bolo Krishna, chant the names of Krishna. Bajo Krishna, worship Krishna. And Koro Krishna Shiksha, read the books about Krishna.
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就这样出现 Bolo Krishna, Bajo Krishna. 就是一个是呼唤 Krishna 的圣名啊，崇拜主 Krishna， 再来是研究关于 Krishna 的这些经典知识。
So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was telling people, everyone, everywhere, he was chanting always the Hare Krishna mantra, chanting the names of Krishna.
所以
and preaching the message of Krishna.
所以主 Chaitanya 就告诉每一个人，就是大家来唱诵主 Krishna 的圣名，然后去传扬 Krishna。
And the color of this incarnation in the Kali Yuga, in each Yuga, the Lord has a different color. So in the Kali Yuga, the Lord's color is described that he is Akrishna, means he is not blackish, he's a different color. He is Krishna, but he is not blackish.
Krishna 在每一个不同的年代的化身，身体的肤色会不一样。那在这一个年代呢，他的颜色称为 Akrishna， 就是不是 Krishna 那个黑色，就是他身体的肤色不是那个黝黑那个颜色。
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was like that. He was a golden color, a golden complexion.
所以主持人马可夫是这样子的、啊、出现他的身体的肤色是这个金黄色的。
And that golden complexion is significant because this is the color of Srimati Radharani.
而他身体肤色是金黄色是非常显著的，因为那是啊圣 Radharani 的身体的肤色。
And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna, but he has come in the mood of the devotee.And the topmost of all devotees is Srimati Radharani.
所以呢，主持人嘛，普普他出现，他自己是 Krishna 本人，但是他的心境是圣 Radharani， 因为 Radharani 是 Krishna 最崇高、最伟大的奉献者。
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he has come, and he's in the mood of.Radha Baba Juti Sabalitam, that he's got this emotion of Radha, the love, the Baba, the feeling of devotion which was there in the heart of Srimati Radharani.
所以呢，Chaitanya Prabhu 他出现的那种感情，灵性感情是 Radha Baba， 就是圣 Radharani 拥有对 Krishna 那种爱、挚爱的感情。
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna, but he's come in the mood of the devotee, Srimati Radharani, to experience the ecstasy of love of Krishna.
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is Krishna 本人，但是他以圣 Radharani 的感情出现，然后展示对主的爱的这种最高狂喜的这种爱。
5,000 years ago, Lord Krishna came as a cowherd boy, and he liked to experience the pleasure of pastimes with his devotees.
5,000 年前的时候呢 ，Krishna 出现啊，在 Vrindavan， 他在重新体会跟他奉献着这些牧牛童在一起的逍遥活动。
Lord Krishna likes to enjoy, just like all of us.We all like to enjoy.
主 Krishna 喜欢享受享乐，就像我们也都很喜欢享受。
Lord Krishna is the supreme enjoyer. He likes to enjoy unlimitedly.
Krishna 是至尊享乐者，他喜欢无限的享受。
But 5,000 years ago, when he came, he found that while he was enjoying the enjoyment, the pleasure which he got was nothing compared to the pleasure which was being had by his devotees.
5000年前的时候 Krishna 出现，他的享乐远远比不上他的奉献者们对他服务的那一种享受。
He liked to enjoy, but the devotees were enjoying more, much more than him.
Krishna 他喜欢享受，可是他的奉献者。 享受的比他多得多了。
We say it's better to give than to receive.
我们俗话又说，付出比接受更好，施比受更有福。
There's more pleasure in giving than in receiving.
去付出去给予是。 那种快乐胜过于去接收。
Lord Krishna was receiving. From all of his devotees, they were all worshipping him, they were offering their love, their respect to him.
Krishna 就是一直在接受他的奉献者给他的各种奉爱，他奉献者怀着很大的奉爱，一直在给他奉献。
So Lord Krishna was enjoying their love, but they were enjoying much more. By giving their love to Krishna.
所以 Krishna 他在享受的奉献者对他的爱，但是他的奉献者们享受的比 Krishna 来的多多了。So
Krishna decided he should come as a devotee.
所以 Krishna 就决定他应该出现，他应该出来来身为奉献者的身份。Then
he can experience that ultimate pleasure.
那这样他可以自己亲身在体会这最高的娱乐，最高的快乐。And
this is the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
那这是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的心境。He
simply wants to love Krishna, to experience that ecstasy, the pleasure of service to Krishna.
他仅仅只是想要来。 体会经验 Krishna 所经过奉献者这种狂喜。
And it is described in Srimad Bhagavatam how in the Kali Yuga the Lord will come and he will be engaged in Krishna's activities, he will be chanting the holy name and he will be a different color from Krishna, he will not be black.
那经典的佛教还有描述啊，预言的 Krishna 在这个年代会出现，他描述他的出现呢，会跟原来他自己是 Krishna 的身体的肤色会不一样，然后会进行所有关于 Krishna 活动啊，念诵圣名啊，唱诵这一切服务。
And he'll be with all of his devotees. And they will have also the instruments for chanting the holy name.
而且呢，他一直都会跟他的奉献者在一起，同时有着那个唱诵的各种乐器。
So this is described in Srimad Bhagavatam.
所以这在圣典薄伽瓦坛描述着。
And we can see Lord Chaitanya perfectly fits this description.
而我们可以见到呢，就Chaitanya的所有的一切都跟经典符合。And
there are other verses also in Mahabharata. There's another verse.
然后在伟大的摩诃波罗多里面也有其他的诗节的叙述。Which
also describes very clearly the activities of Lord Chaitanya.
在那伟大的摩诃波罗多里面也有很多描述，很清楚的描述的主Chaitanya的活动。So
we accept Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as being the Kali Yuga avatar.
所以我们接受主Chaitanya Mahaprabhu是在卡利年代的化身。And
he comes to establish the process for the Kali Yuga.
而他的出现是在卡利年代。 把这个宗教程序建立起来。That
process being the chanting of the holy name in the form of Sankirtan.
那个程序就是说 唱颂主的圣名，以 Sankita 就是齐聚大家一起来唱颂。
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is completing the mission of Lord Krishna.
所以主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就完成了 Krishna 给他的 Krishna 的使命。
Lord Krishna said, "Surrender." Chaitanya Mahaprabhu shows us how to surrender.
Krishna 说的要臣服，那主 Chaitanya， 他展示着如何来臣服。
Are there any questions?
在座各位有没有任何问题？
我有个问题 ，Krishna 这个名字是在不同的年代，都是叫 Krishna 吗？还是 Krishna 这个名字是 Krishna 最爱，还是最 final 的一个名字这样？
Krishna's name in different ages, different yoga has same name or different name, and the name of Krishna is the Lord's.Ultimate, the last name, or not?
Yeah, Krishna has many names.
是的 ，Krishna 有很多的名字。
When Lord Krishna appeared, he was taken to the home of Nanda Maharaj. And at that time, Vasudeva, the father, he arranged for Garga Muni to go there to do the name-giving ceremony of the child.
是啊，Krishna 的出现的时候，在苏代瓦那边，后来到南达大君家里，然后把苏代瓦安排嘎嘎母女去到南达大君家里帮 Krishna 命名。
Right, Garga Muni, he was the Brahmana priest. So he did the astrological calculation, the chart, and then he gave the name, and he told Nanda Maharaj about Lord Krishna, about his past. He told him that this child appears different colors in different ages.
所以这个嘎嘎母女她是一个就像我们说算命这种婆罗门星象婆罗门，那他就把 Krishna 的出生时辰这样排列，然后告诉南达大君，就是说。Krishna， 你这个孩子呢，在以前的不同年代都曾经出现过。
And he told him how in this time there will be dangers, there will be many dangers which the child will be faced with, but he will overcome all of them.
同时也告诉南达大君，就说你现在这个孩子在这个时候出现的。这个年代里面，他会经历很多的危险，但都会一一被克服。
And this child will be almost as good. He'll be like Narayan.
你这个孩子会那么好的，就像主 Narayan 那样。
He did. Garga Muni did not actually tell Nanda Maharaj that your child is God. He didn't want to disturb.Them by telling him that he's actually the supreme lord.
那嘎嘎牟尼呢？他没有告诉南达大君或其他人说这个孩子就是至尊主，因为他不想打扰大家的想法，认为这个就是至尊主，而把他当作一个平常孩子来看。
But that name Krishna was there for the child.
Krishna 这个名字就是对我们说到了五千年前出现那个 Krishna 就是用他那个名字。
Of course, he has many other names.
Krishna 有很多很多的名字。
He's also known as Vasudeva, the son of Vasudeva, the father's Vasudeva, so he's named after his father.
所以 Krishna 也有那个瓦苏代瓦这个名字，因为他是他代表 Krishna 华苏代瓦的父亲。
He was kept in the home of Nanda Maharaj, so he's Nanda Nandana, one who gives pleasure to Nanda Maharaj.
那他是在南达大君的家里，他叫做 Nanda Nandana， 就是给予南达大君快乐的这个人。
He's also Yashoda Nandana.
他也是 Yashoda Nandana.
He gave a lot of pleasure to Mother Yashoda.
给予 Yashoda 母亲很多的快乐。
He is loved by all the residents of Vrindavan.
他被本达文所有的居民所爱着。
Gopijana Balabha, another name of Krishna, one who gives pleasure to the gopis.
Gopijana Balabha 就是给予牧牛姑娘们快乐的人。
And then of course Giri Bharadari, when he picked up the Govardhan Hill.
还有就是 Giri Dari, 就是他举起 Govardhan 山的人。
So he's known by his different pastimes.
所以就由他的各种不同的逍遥活动的给他的这些特别的名字。
We were singing a song this morning, different names of Lord Krishna.
像我们今天早晨大家一起唱诵，是我们唱诵的 Krishna 的不同的名字。
Mukunda.Bolo Hari Hari, Mukunda Murari, Ramakrishna Hayagriva. There are so many beautiful names of Krishna.
就像我们歌本里面也有很多，也有一些特别是为 Krishna 的名字，就说 Mukunda Bolo Hari Hari,
Yashomati Nandana, Vrajabharanagara, Gokula Ranjana Kana, Yamuna Jivana.Kali Parayana, all names of Krishna.
很多很多就是 Krishna, Maharaj 刚刚说到的那些名字，我们都知道，都是 Krishna 的各种活动特征表示的。
We say actually God has no name.
Who said that?
We say.
We say. 我们说事实上神没有名字。
But he's known by his different past.
但是他是经由他不同的逍遥时光而被知晓。
By his different activities, his relationships with his devotees.
经由他的不同的活动啦，还有经由他跟不同奉献者之间的关系，而给他一些那些特定的名字。
Srila Prabhupada named some of the different deities of Krishna.With beautiful names, very interesting names.
那圣巴乌帕对于我们ISKCON开光的庙的神像，用过很多不同 Krishna 的那一些逍遥时光用到的名字，有一些名字很有趣。
For example, in New Delhi, we have a temple there in east of Kailash, and he called the deities there are known as.Radha Partha Sarathi.
就像我们在新德里启东的一个庙在这个东凯拉什地区的那个庙，包括把那神像名字叫 Radha Partha Sarathi.
So Partha Sarathi means the chariot driver of Arjuna.
Partha Sarathi 的意思说是帮阿朱那驾车的人。
But it's unusual that he's given that name when he's with Radharani.
So, 这也是很不寻常的，因为 Krishna 现在跟 Radharani 在一起，但是用了这个在战场上的这个用名。
Another name Prabhupada gave was Radha Paris Ishwara. The deity in Paris is called Paris Ishwara.
还有另外一个有趣的名字，就是说在法国巴黎那个神像哈，包括他给那神像名字是 Radha Parishvari， 就是巴黎的主
神。Parishvara。
Parishvara。
And then London Ishvara。Radha London Ishvara。
在伦敦也是 Radha London Ishvara。当地的控制者。
Gokulananda,
Gokulanandana,
another deity of Krishna, Radha, in the Bhaktivedanta manner in London, they call Radha Gokulananda.
然后在英国伦敦巴利维丹达的农庄对神像是 Radha Gokulanandana.
Not Anandana, Radha Gokul Ananda.
Radha Gokul Ananda.
Right? So these different names of Krishna.
所以这一些对 Krishna 的各种啊各个不同的名字。
Means he gives pleasure to all the people of Gokul, the bliss of Gokula.
啊，就是像刚刚讲的这个名字，就是 Krishna 给 Gokula 的居民快乐的人。
And he got the name Govinda because he was protecting the cow.
嗯，然后 Krishna 还有名字是 Govinda， 就是他保护乳牛的人。
After he picked up the Govardhan Hill, that was when he protected all the cows, and then Indra gave the name Govinda to Lord Krishna.
在 Krishna 举起 Govardhan 山之后呢，啊，因陀罗给 Krishna 这个名字 Govinda， 因为 Krishna 是保护乳牛的人。
But Lord Brahma, he'd also called Krishna Govinda in his prayers when Lord Brahma offered prayers to Krishna.He said, Govindam Adipursham Tamaham Vadam.
那像梵天婆罗诃摩也把 Krishna 用一个名字 Govinda， 就是在婆罗诃摩在或者我们开启神像那句啊 ，Govindam Adipursham Tamaham Vadami， 就是那个时候用 Govinda。
So Lord Krishna's names are the so many names.
所以 Krishna 的名字有很多很多，也可以说是无数的名字。
Just as Krishna has many different forms, he's Ananta Rup. He has many different, countless forms. He has also countless names.
就像 Krishna， 他有无数个展示的形体，所以他的名字也无数，就是 Ananta Rup， Ananta Rup。
好 ，Roger， 请问，我看到一个视频，就念那个 Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya 跟唱诵 Hare Krishna 的曼陀罗有没有差别？
He asking when he see sometime there's chanting Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, is there any difference with the Mahamantra or not?
Well.Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. We're offering our obeisances to the Supreme Personality of Godhead Vasudev.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, 就是我们向至尊人格首神 Vasudeva 来致敬礼拜。
This mantra was chanted by Dhruva Maharaj. It was given to him by his guru Narada Muni.
啊，这是杜鲁国王他在唱诵的，是由他的灵性导师纳达穆尼教给他的。
So it's also the holy name of the Lord.
啊，这个名字也是主的圣名之一。
And the holy name of the Lord can destroy all amounts of sins.
那主的圣名可以。毁掉所有的罪恶，摧毁所有的罪恶。
And it can also give us transcendental knowledge.
同时主的圣名也可以给我们超然的知识。
So in every age there was a chanting of the holy names, but not always the same mantra or the same name.
所以在每个年代都有唱诵主的圣名这样的活动，但是。唱诵主的圣名，不见得是每个年代主的相同的名字。
We are chanting the Maha Mantra, Hare Krishna Mantra, because Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu chanted Hare Krishna Mantra.
我们在念诵、唱诵这个 Hare Krishna Maha Mantra， 是因为主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他在唱诵这个 Maha Mantra， Hare Krishna Maha Mantra。
And Prabhupada liked to hear the Hare Krishna mantra.
And Prabhupada 也喜欢听到听着这个 Hare Krishna Maha mantra.
So we are chanting for the pleasure of Lord Chaitanya, Srila Prabhupada.
所以我们唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra 就是取悦 Prabhupada 取悦主 Chaitanya.
Of course, you can also chant Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
当然，你也可以来念诵 Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
But we prefer to chant Hare Krishna.
但是我们比较喜欢来念诵 Hare Krishna.
Guru Maharaj, you mentioned that
you said that Krishna, he likes to enjoy unlimitedly, but the devotees enjoy more than him. But it's also said in the Chaitanya Charitamrita that the gopis, they enjoy even more, millions of times more than Radharani. So how to understand that?
The gopis enjoy more than Radharani?
Yeah.
刚刚他在问说，刚刚 Maharaj 有提到奉献者们的享受远远胜过 Krishna 他自己的享受。那又说到呢，在永恒 Chaitanya 经里面描述到牧牛姑娘们的快乐，他们的享受远远胜过 Radharani 的快乐。
这怎么样来了解这段叙述？马上说他最好先看他前后文的叙述。肯定的就是牧牛姑娘们的快乐享受的远远千百万倍。
胜过 Krishna 的那种快乐。But
I don't remember seeing that the gopis enjoy more than Srimati Radharani.
可是我不确定，我不记得里面有描述说牧牛姑娘们的这些享受远胜过 Radharani.
Well, Radharani is one of the gopis.
同时 Radharani 她也是牧牛姑娘。
So it's difficult for me to see. How this can be, but if you show me the section, it would help.
所以直接这样一句话很难去判断，那就是最好把这那个诗节或那个文章来读一下，可以知道整个情况。
Understood it is that Krishna is so magnanimous that he is giving his devotees more pleasure than he himself feels. That's the way I kind of understood it.
所以就刚刚前面这些叙述，我们可以这样来理解，就是啊， Krishna 是非常的仁慈，非常的宽宏大量，他。
Well, yes, the devotees are enjoying the pleasure of the service to Krishna.
奉献者们在享受的是，他们对 Krishna 服务之这个过程中的快乐。
Yeah, we could say Krishna is giving them the pleasure.
我们可以说是 Krishna 给这些在做服务的奉献者们给予他们快乐。The
gopis, all the devotees who are serving Krishna, they're getting that pleasure, that satisfaction from giving something to Krishna.
所以奉献者们呢，还有牧牛姑娘们呢，他们的满足在于就是 Krishna 赋予他们。 奉献给 Krishna 的这些活动、这些服务里面的快乐。
We don't really have anything to give to Krishna. Krishna, everything is His.
所以我们实际上没有什么东西可以给 Krishna， 因为所有一切都是 Krishna 的。
But if we can give our love to Krishna，
但是我们可以把我们的爱给 Krishna。
So that is the greatest pleasure.
所以这是最大的快乐，最大的愉悦。And
the devotees experience that pleasure. They experience that ecstasy, that happiness which comes from giving and surrendering themselves to Krishna.
所以奉献者会直接的体会到，当就是跟 Krishna 臣服那样的服务，完全臣服的。
Yeah, you can say it comes from Krishna. Everything comes from Krishna.
那你可以说啊，这是从 Krishna 那儿来的，因为这也是事实，就是一切都是 Krishna 的。
The ecstasy of devotional service is also coming from Krishna.
所以在奉爱服务里面的喜乐狂喜也是 Krishna 给的，是从 Krishna 来的。
Krishna is appreciating that love.
Krishna 是在感激的这种爱，在欣赏的这种爱。
So Krishna is Bhakta Vatsala. He reciprocates with the love of his devotees.
So Krishna, he is Bhakta Vatsala, 就是他跟他的奉献者们在交流回应。
And because the gopis gave everything to Krishna, Krishna told them that I can't repay you.
因为奉献者们把所有一切都给 Krishna 了，所以
is online.
Okay.
Anna Maya Jurassica saying, Gurudev, Chinese verse, 请接受我的鞠躬。我注意到当我念诵 Japa 时，我会遗漏念珠上的一些珠子，我该如何对抗呢？我听说应向 Gopal 来供应适合儿童食用的食物。如果只有 Gopal 在家，其余的食物应该供给谁呢？两个 question. First one.Gurudev, please say my homage. I noticed while I'm chanting Japa, sometimes I just miss some beats. How to rectify this or how to avoid this happening?
Chant with more attention.
林静老师说，更加的用心专注念诵，专心念诵。And second question, she heard some people say if they want to offer food for the children, so the best is offered to Gopal Deity. But this for children, and what about those adults? Which deity we should offer and then give to the adults people?
Well, Lord Krishna is absolute. If you're offering everything to Bala Gopal, to the child Krishna, you can continue to offer it to him.
Krishna 的各种形体都是绝对，是绝对真理。所以呢，你已经向Bala Gopal 在供奉食物的话，其他的就这样继续进行这样的供奉。
You don't need a special deity.
如果是这样子，就不需要再有其他的神像，其他任何特别神像。
Okay.
Yeah. Next one. 妈妈，你是 Krishna， 只有和朋友在一起时才会遇到恶魔。那 Krishna 跟 Gopi 在一起时，恶魔会攻击他吗？妈妈，你是so far.Hearing that Krishna will encounter the demons is only when he was with Gopal. But when Krishna was the gopi, they will be attacked by the demons or not?
Yes, sometimes.
是的，有时候Krishna 跟牧牛姑娘们在一起也会受到恶魔的骚扰。
Yes, there were some demons trying to.
是的，是有一些恶魔也要去骚扰 Krishna 跟牧牛姑娘。
But Krishna always protects his devotees.
Krishna 总是会来保护他的奉献者们。Yeah, the question so far, these three questions.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, Hare Krishna, Shiva Prabhupada ki
jai.
Yeah.